Many organizations want to get to autonomous networks, essentially networks that will take care of themselves. Now, if we look at the networks of today, they haven't really reached that level yet. They do typically have some level of automation and some level of machine learning and some amount of AI, but there's still a ways to go to reach autonomy. Now, the fact is, IT networks, they just generate an awful lot of data, more data than humans can parse in real time. And that data, it moves places. It moves across domains and in and out of network silos, which means the data is not always visible or accessible to us. And it also inhibits our ability to transform network operations to keep up with the data and demands. And AI for networking can help with all this. But before I explain how, let's better understand the problem that networks face today. And the first of those is signal versus noise. So think about a network operation center on a busy day. There's screens flashing and there's all sorts of alerts that are flying in. Now, the thing is, most of those alerts will never be investigated. In fact, they're just going to get ignored. And why is that? Well, it's not because the teams don't care. It's because those teams are drowning in noise. And most of those alerts, they're actually going to be false positive alerts anyway. And that really masks the real issues that need urgent attention. And it just kind of leaves teams guessing at which signals actually matter. So that's one factor. Another factor to consider is data volume and accessibility. Just the amount of data, all of this data that's coming in, the velocity of it, and the complexity of this telemetry data is overwhelming. There is just so much of it, and much of that data is siloed data. It's all over the place, and that makes it very difficult to get at different vendor and network domains where that data is, and it makes cross-domain analysis pretty tricky to do. So that's the problem. How can AI for networking actually help with this? Now, look, on this channel, we try to make the point that AI isn't magic. It's not some black box that fixes everything. So what we mean by AI for networking is actually a combination of some form of AI added in with some form of automation as well, and then adding on to that some form of analytics. That's really what we're talking about building. And the goal here is that we will combine these things to create networks that can, to some extent, actually understand what's going on within that network, and then also decide what to do, and then also act on that decision and to do that on their own. And a good way to explain how and where they do this is through the day zero and day one and day two structure. So if we think about this, day zero, that is planning and design. This is before you even buy the gear. Now, in the context of day zero, AI here, that means optimizing network design to make smarter CapEx decisions. And in case you're wondering, CapEx, that just means capital expense. So one-time purchases like routers and switches. So what's happening here is the AI analyzes historical patterns and it builds designs optimized for efficient operations. And if it works, instead of overbuilding everywhere, you get right-sized performance and better CapEx efficiency. That's day zero. Now, day one, that is build and deployment. So now you're deploying new services, you're configuring devices, you're bringing new capacity online. And when it comes to day one, AI here, that can accelerate all of this through dynamic network optimization. And it does that by validating configurations before they go into production, by optimizing service paths in real time and by learning from each deployment. And when we get down to day two, that is operations. Now, this is where actually most of the AI work really happens. And that includes high fidelity anomaly detection. And that uses our old friend, Agentic AI. Yes, I got this many minutes into the video before mentioning Agentic AI. That may be a personal best. Now, Agentic AI here, that means an AI that can reason about problems rather than just flagging them. It ingests data across all of those siloed domains and vendors that I mentioned earlier. And it uses domain-tuned models, which is AI specifically trained on network data, to find the real issues. So rather than just saying, here's an alert, something went wrong, what this will actually do is give us a root cause of the problem. And that root cause was derived through a chain of reasoning which bounds the model with network guardrails. And agents do, of course, have agency. So once the root cause is identified, the agentic AI can do something about it, which is to say it can trigger remediation. And that remediation will use existing automation tools to try to fix the problem. So where does all this lead? Well, most organizations do start at day two, and that's operations. And why do they start at day two? Well, because that's where most of the everyday pain is, the tickets, the outages, your 3 a.m. wake-up calls. But get this, once day two is working, the AI starts feeding intelligence backwards. All of that operational data, all those patterns of what actually breaks, well, that becomes training data for better day zero planning and for better day one building. The AI learns the network's specific behavior. Those capacity models, they get smarter, that right-sized performance gets more right-sized. It's basically a continuous feedback loop. Now, remember the end game here, what we're trying to get is a network that can kind of take care of itself, which we're calling network autonomy. Now, you can tell the network here what you want. Let's say prioritize network traffic or optimize for lowest latency. And this autonomous network will figure out how. And it can be done with humans in the loop as well. So the AI can handle some of the grunt work, the repetitiveness of all those similar tickets, and human teams can focus on the complex stuff, the strategic decisions. So look, AI for networking isn't magic. It's pattern recognition at a scale that no human team alone could ever match. It means networks that learn and adapt and resolve issues on their own. And in a world of siloed data and false positive alerts, a system that can handle all of that, well, it might be all the magic that we really need.